Let us take, what is stress?
Here, for explaining stress, I am taking one object, one body here. Okay, like this. Now I am applying some force along this direction. So obviously this object or this body will move in this direction. So our next assumption is we have to make this body in equilibrium, means we have to apply the same force in the opposite direction. At the time it is in equilibrium condition. Okay. According to Newton's third law, for equal action there is always equal and opposite reaction for getting the equilibrium. Okay. Now this body is in equilibrium. As we know, if you are applying force, this body will try to elongate, it will deform, because whatever we are taking the objects or bodies, according to first assumption, it should be deformable. Okay. When we are applying this force, this body will try to deform. Okay. It is coming, it will elongate along this length. Okay. As we know, every object has molecules inside it. Okay. Molecular arrangement will be there. Whenever this object will deform or elongate in the force direction, the molecules also elongate. So we are studying this effect. Okay, just draw the line here. This is a separate part. Now we are taking this part. This side is PE is applying, and this side resistive forces. Object will try to elongate along the force direction. But here, if you see the internal arrangement of molecules, each and every molecule will try to come back in the opposite direction. Or it is coming to its, it will try to come in the original position. Let us take this molecule is producing P1 force. This is producing P2 force, P3, P4 in the opposite direction. But this side is PE is applying, and this side resistive forces. Okay. So this is our main part now. Sum of all these resistance forces is called total resistive force. Okay. Is there any method of calculating internal forces? So it is difficult to calculate each and every molecule force inside the body. So that's why for equilibrium, whatever sum of all resistance forces, it is equal to the applied force. So I am taking this is the applied force. Okay. So whenever these molecules are coming back to its original position, means we can tell this object is under stress. So stress means it is nothing but total force, total resistance force for a given area, per unit area we can call. So I have written the definition here. It is a total resistance force, or instead of total, it is the resistance force of the molecule to the deformation per given area. So here I have written stress is equal to, what is a total resistance force means? It is nothing but P. P is the applied force divided by this area. Throughout the cross section area we are taking capital A. It is circular, that's why pi by 4 d square. Now take the area here. So what are the units for stress? As we know, for force it is Newton. And for area it is meter square, Newton by meter square. Okay. Sometimes they are giving in terms of Pascal. 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton by meter square. Sometimes they are giving kilopascal. Kilo means 10 cube. Okay. Pascal means Newton per meter square. It is kilopascal. Sometimes giving megapascal, mega means 10 power 6, pascal means Newton per meter square. Sometimes given gigapascal, okay, 10 power 9, giga means 10 power 9, pascal means Newton per meter square. These are the main important points in today's class. In next class, we will see what are the types of stresses.